Slack is a new way to communicate with your team. Messaging that's faster, better organized, and more secure. Conversations happen in channels that are easy to create, join, and search. Try it for free at slack.com. Slack, where work happens.
Christopher Media, the Toddzilla X-Pod.
I don't like shooing people away, but it's good practice sometimes. Some people like me, some people can't fucking stand me. I'm polarizing, I get that. But I think it's fair that I should come with a warning label. Then I should get that out there before you stumble into something thinking it's going to be something it's not.
The Toddzilla X-Pod on iTunes and ChristopherMedia.net. Christopher Media, let's make some noise. From Asthma Core Studios near Detroit, Michigan, it's Unregimented.
Gangsters, what's up, guys?
It's going even better than I was hoping it would.
It is, actually.
Where's Chris? We need a petition. I thought Chris was on this podcast.
Fuck off.
Yeah, but we have a good board up.
I know, you're like Diesel on the old Mike Valenti and Foster show. You're just in the back, and every once in a while you just go, lather up in that lion's butter, yeah, pull out them old bits, yeah.
And another thing. Here's what I think about the Blacks.
I do actually appreciate you calling me out there on the stats, actually, because like not knowing them is not a good thing. So
hold the appreciation for now, because I'm sure I'm gonna.
I already said fuck you, so I gotta say, you know, I appreciate something.
No, I know. That's nothing.
That's a greeting for us. Hey, fuck you, man. Hey, fuck you too. You know, how you been then?
No, I appreciate where you're coming from.
Yeah. Well, I appreciate everybody's point of view, man.
I don't.
Like, I appreciate it, but it's, you know,
yeah.
you have the right.
I am just so glad I'm no
longer. You have
longer
the right to your opinion, and I have the right to think that it's poor shit.
It's more like Jesus loves you, but I still think you're an asshole. That kind of bumper sticker. Yeah,
Loves you. Everyone else thinks you're a cunt.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah. Thank you. I appreciate the you know.
But no, candor. No. I'm just so glad that I'm not the only painted into a corner gun guy now. When he started,
we're all gun guys.
Jay, when you started bringing that shit up, I was like,
Aaron shot a gun before.
Good. Yeah. Now I have somebody on my corner.
There's nobody here who's anti-gun.
No, I agree with you. No, Aaron. Who? Aaron, I
you?
You know, Aaron.
I'm more pro Second Amendment than I am pro gun.
Pro gun.
That's yes.
Let's start.
Start back.
Yeah, we'll still go on. But yeah, the Second Amendment, though.
Are great,
here's the thing that the problem that I have with constitutional fundamentalists is that they think that that Jesus came down from on high, sat down with Ben Franklin and Thomas Jefferson and John Adams. Yeah, and Independence Hall was
in
transported
Philly.
Over to some fucking mound in the middle of fucking Jerusalem, and that's where they
take that.
This is why
Holy
we can't
shit.
Have nice things.
I was that was the force of my speech.
You're talking. Shit about Jesus.
Jesus
Look Christ. At that. See, you're talking shit.
Wait.
That's what happens when you talk shit about
right.
the Christ.
The five-man battle royale is officially tearing the studio apart.
All I wanted to do was stand up and extend it.
I've got the boom.
That's
just grab
what
the
she
clamp
said.
There.
Oh, the clamp came off yours.
The clamp popped off the table. That's what my problem is.
The force of the Toddzillian message has knocked the microphone stand off the clamp, and now they're trying to repair it.
Todd, you know the right saying, that's what you get for talking about Jesus. You don't be talking shit about Jesus.
That was Jesus that
did that. That was Jesus come down and smack you upside the head.
That was Jesus. Will you grab me a PBR?
Yes, I will.
Poor favor.
Can you make that?
Think thin. Okay. You need one?
Yeah, if you don't mind.
All right.
I like the way this is going, actually.
Okay.
This is
glad
a good,
I can. I hope I'm adding something. I'm glad I can.
No,
I'm enjoying
absolutely.
Myself. I really am. Thank you very much. I appreciate the invite.
Okay, so, but to your point about constitutional fundamentalists, don't they miss the whole point of the Constitution in the first place, which was to have a document that you could amend as your society grows and matures and changes?
It's on, listen, it's written in stone. Okay, you know how they say the Ten
Commandments? I saw it, it's in paper.
No.
I saw it, it's on a piece of fucking paper.
No,
you can't even read it.
No, it's not.
I saw it.
Yeah, I'm going to blow your fucking mind. You know how they say the Ten Commandments are written in stone? They were etched into stone? The fact that the Constitution is amendable is literally written in stone. It's written on one of the sides of the Jefferson fucking memorial.
Oh, my mind.
It was meant to be amended as future generations saw fit or something. You find it on your fucking tab.
I'll buy it for you. You know, whatever. I don't need Google.
No.
Believe you.
No, but
I believe you.
It's,
I do too.
They knew that it was an imperfect document.
Yeah. Right.
They knew that it fit their times. It was the best they come up with. But they did not want their ancestors to be held to the tyranny of their forefathers.
Exactly.
In other words, they said that holding future generations to their version of the Constitution would be like forcing an adult to wear a child's coat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They literally said that. I remember that line. Jefferson literally said that. So if you are a constitutional fundamentalist, if you think that the Constitution was delivered by the hand of fucking Jesus, you're fucked in the head. They knew that it was meant to be evolved. They knew that it was meant to be amended as time went on, as culture and society evolved. You hear that? You hear that? You fucking religious fuck. As evolution, social evolution took place.
Devolving, actually. I mean,
because there are people in this society that are trying to retard us.
Right.
There are parts of us that are trying to evolve, and then there are other parts who are like this fucking this parasite in the brain that's keeping the brain of a fucking like a 7-year-old from developing into a full grown adult. It's just like holding you back. It's like onto the brainstem. It's
like the brain slugs on Futurama.
It's
right. Well, it's a difference.
I yield.
It's a misunderstanding of what it means to have rights. You know, we've really confused what our rights are in this nation. Like we think that we have a right to water. You know, people are protesting in Michigan because they're shutting the water off because they haven't paid. Well, that's not a right to have running water. There's a difference between you have the right to carry a firearm, but Jay understands that right comes with responsibility.
Exactly.
You know, and it's not your right to have a firearm the same way it's everyone's right to speak their mind. Any idiot can speak their mind, but not any idiot can own a gun or possibly even drive a car.
Everybody has the right to their opinion. Everybody has the right to their opinion, but not all opinions are equal.
Now, I guess I would be considered like a communist by saying this, but I think we should really have a you should have to have a license to have children.
Obviously. Yes, buddy.
I'm with you.
In my opinion.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah. Yep. Yeah, absolutely.
That is a dangerous road to go down.
Why? I understand the danger of that because now you're infringing on the people's right to have sex. I can't.
No, you should be able to fuck. I think you should be neutered or fixed at the age of 3. And then when you get through. Seriously. No, really. But this is great. I'm available for children's parties, by the way.
Yes, obviously.
You should be fixed at the age of 3. And then when you prove that you have the mental capacity to be able to think and actually responsibly raise a spawn, then maybe they should figure out a way to reverse the procedure later on.
And the way to do that
is
you own an animal. From the point it's taken from its mother to the point where it dies naturally.
Like that, what is that? Like that high school home economic? Where you take care of an egg for a week?
Yeah.
And I'm the good teacher with that. That's something.
But you're talking about selective breeding being
eugenics.
Decided.
Let's call it eugenics.
Selective breeding decided by who? The government?
Me. No, I'll do it.
It's
not necessarily selective breeding, it's reduction of breeding.
Worked for China.
Yeah, it
does. Yeah.
There is an overpopulation problem.
Like
have we not forgotten
like,
about
like
that?
Like I did say, I might be considered communist by saying
not
that,
this
which
nation.
I don't.
Globally.
It's a distribution problem.
Globally.
Is what we have.
It's. Are you saying it's a good theory on paper?
I'm saying it's a good theory in my head and probably shouldn't have put it on paper.
I'm sorry, what's a good theory?
Communism. Because we're talking about doing it with children and stuff.
What
is government
like,
license?
What government isn't a good theory on paper? You know, like what government really works? That's the question.
Do you guys know anything about communitarianism?
Communitarianism.
Community, you don't know.
No.
I'm surprised. You're a very smart guy. This is your homework project for this week.
Okay.
I know. Communitarianism is the...
sounds like some hippie shit.
Yeah.
No. it's actually where we're headed. And Naomi Klein, in her new book, talked about this a little bit.
Okay. I was wondering if we were going to get to that because she speaks very ill of capitalism, says it's incongruous with our needs at this point.
Is that more like the co-ops as opposed to corporations? Is that kind of...
You can parse the word. Communitarianism is the governance by community. In other words, it is you have to cooperate. In other words, I can't really describe it without having a common frame of reference. But it's basically the melding of capitalism and socialism.
Okay.
It's a third way. Is how they like to sell it. And there are a lot of people out there that are really skeptical of it. They think it's communism. They think it's just flat out socialism, but it is the future because as Naomi Klein points out in that book of hers, the way things are headed at this point, the globe cannot handle and sustain capitalism unfettered anymore.
No.
It just right. it's the end of the species. Mm-hmm. Think about that. It literally, the science, you're looking at me funny, but the science is pretty fucking solid on this.
I agree with you.
Yeah, the un-oil based science is very, very solid on
this. She was just on Bill Maher last Friday.
I have her book.
Yeah. And she was talking about the book you're talking about. Yeah.
It's the first. I've only gotten about
Colbert, too, I think.
Yeah, she's done Colbert? She's done the whole media.
She was on NPR as well.
She's done the whole media circuit.
I just heard her on NPR and saw her on Colbert.
She's not a literary mill. She's only put out three books that I know of since 98.
Mm-hmm. And everybody's like, oh, you're a Canadian. What do you understand?
Yeah.
She said that on Bill Maher, actually. Yeah, right.
Well, they have different brains than everybody else. So, you know.
No. The Canadian government has apologized many times for Bryan Adams.
What about fucking Justin Bieber?
They got six fingers and an extra toe.
We're working on that one still.
But anyway, the point
is still denying that one.
The whole point comes back to that there has to be a rethinking and a restructuring of society. Democracy, and this goes back to the point that I was talking about, what form of government on paper doesn't work? Democracy on paper works. In theory, it worked to a point. Communism on paper works. You know, if you want to, you know, embrace that utopianism, it works.
Yeah.
But in practice, it doesn't. So we've gone from the failure of communism to the partial success of democracy. I think that if we want to survive as a species, we've got to evolve into communitarianism, and that is flat out liberalism.
Yeah.
Today, it's where liberalism is where the left is taking
you. When you say we, are you talking about a nation or people
globally,
in general?
It's one. It's basically a one government system.
Has any nation in the world ever survived that massive of a change? Like, can you imagine America? United States of America surviving through a transition from capitalism.
We don't have a choice.
Yeah,
literally, we do not have a choice. As a think about, we're getting caught up in these like ideas.
We have a choice. We can just sweep it under the rug
and die. Yeah,
we move to Canada.
Literally, that's my other crutch, by the way.
Literally.
But it is essentially.
You know what I'm saying?
And I'm using this in the right form. It's literally a matter of survival that we can sit here and we can brawl about ideology and tribalism and Ayn Randism. I want to dig up Ayn Rand and burn her fucking body and throw it into the fucking river over here.
We just lost about three people I know that listen.
Yeah, fuck you. We have gotten to the point where if we don't abandon that type of thinking, we don't figure out a way to cooperate. We're dead. We're done.
Okay, hold on. Okay, time out. Let's. Are we really talking democracy or are we talking capitalism?
We're talking capitalism.
Okay. Yeah. And here's the thing. We are a very young country. Mm-hmm. A very young country. We were the fucking little brother that you don't want your friends to see when they come over until what? After World War II?
You can say redheaded stepchild.
World War
I.
It's
okay.
World War I.
My mom was one. I know I can. I carry the gene.
It's okay. Military industrial complex kicked in World War I.
Yeah.
Okay, but after World War II is when really, like, our economy started really taking off to where...
Well, because of World War II, actually. Yes. Yeah, okay. I see what you're saying. Yeah.
And it's only been 70 years, and here we are, and we're coming to, like... I think we can all agree that if shit doesn't change, we're coming to the end of the post-World War II American dream. I mean, if we already haven't buried it, we just haven't had the fucking eulogy for it at this point.
It's not the American dream. It's bigger.
I understand that, but you cannot get people to fucking think that way.
Well, then that's where I said earlier today, I posted something on Facebook that said, what if it's not about who's right or wrong, but if the entire species is just fucked in the head? You know, because if you can't get past that, if you can't get past that sort of petty difference, and you're willing to let yourself die and let the entire planet be just wiped out, at least as far as an inhabitatory, if that's even a word, level.
You know what? I don't care because I got my SUV. I have my SUV, so fuck it all.
I'm not even going to laugh because there are so many fucking people that say, well, I got my fucking incandescent light bulbs. Fuck the planet. Fuck them dolphins. Fuck them goddamn. Yeah, well, whatever. Yeah, fuck you. Yeah. At some point, you've got to look at yourself in the mirror. And we have to look at ourselves in the mirror collectively as a fucking species, as an intelligent, introspective species, and say, you know what? Something's fucking wrong
here. No, man. No. It's just like I quoted.
I don't agree with you on that.
I quoted this movie. It was a bullshit throw. throwaway movie, but it was, to me, a very valid quote. A person is smart, people are stupid.
Absolutely.
Yep.
It is.
Yeah, baby.
Give me some of that window glove. No, no window glove.
Was that Idiocracy? Because that movie.
No, that was actually Men in Black, unfortunately.
Oh, that's one of my favorite quotes. Yeah. That's people are smart. A person is smart, people are stupid.
And as we collectively as a people, we can't even. I've seen friendships end in the last couple weeks over the fucking new iPhone, for fuck's sake.
What?
On Facebook, motherfuckers that have known each other since high school, like, well, fuck you, you Apple fuck, go suck on fucking his cold, hard dick, blah, blah, blah. You got some block user in your future, faggot. And I'm like, what kind of... Are you serious? Over a fucking preference?
Dude, I've had that happen to me, man. Go figure, some people find me a little abrasive.
Yeah, but you enjoy that, though.
No, seriously, dude.
I get the same thing.
But I've had a lot of friendships over the last 4 years that have ended just simply because of like shit that you and I went through last week. I seriously thought that was done, man. Because I've been through that so many fucking times that I'm just used to people just...
Well, really?
Yeah.
Over that?
Yeah.
We've had worse conversations.
No, it had that smell to it, where it gets to that certain point of personalism, where you start to personalize the discussion, and it's just done. I've lost dozens of friends that way over the last 4 years. I mean, friends that I've had for like 20 years. But there's something about that. There's something about the impersonalism of the internet or something that I don't know what it is.
Well, there's no
inflection.
Because
you can't hear inflections in typing. Yeah.
People take it. I don't do that normally, but there you go. I had to get that one.
No, people take it how they take it in their head, and it's
Hold that thought that you were talking about. I want to get back to that disagreement you had.
Well, just because a lot of times I'm of the theory like it's. I didn't say that offensive. You took it offensive. Like
I didn't take it offensively. I just wanted to challenge.
I mean in general.
Okay,
time out.
How about letting the rest of us in on this joke? Because right now, two guys are laughing
their asses
off.
How about you get in the 21st century and get on Facebook? It was right there for everybody to see.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I had
real life come into, like, moving.
Yeah, right. That's show prep for the fucking pod, okay?
this is what I think about as far as how people take things on the internet, because it is all in their own head, and it reminds me of actually a Sesame Street skit where there was something that happened between Bert and Ernie, right? I don't remember the specifics of it, but Bert was convinced that Ernie was going to be mad about it. And he went through this whole, he kind of played it out in his head and had the conversation in his head of like him talking to Ernie. And then when he came home and finally talked to him, Ernie was just like, hey, Bert, how's it going? And Bert's like, just freaks out on him and is totally already in that angry mode.
Because he convinced himself that was where it was going to go in his head before he even had the conversation.
Right.
So,
I do that every day.
We all do.
But they do. But you can apply a certain logic to it. I think some people, they read something that you posted online think, well, that's what he believes. No, this is a thought that occurred to me at the moment. That's why I have this Facebook, so I can go, oh, this thought occurred to me. Somebody else might find this interesting. Boom.
So what this is doing...
Here's my mental diarrhea for today.
Right.
No, what it's doing is throwing kerosene on the personal internal narratives that we all have.
Yeah.
You know, we sort of fill in the blanks and fill in the ideas and how we expect people to react or how we think people are thinking or reacting to us or what we think or what we've said. So we fill in these blanks and we create these narratives that we expect to sort of happen. Right?
Yes.
And we apply our emotions as though it's reality, but it's just something that's fucking being thrown around and bounced around in our skulls.
I do that just as much as anybody, but I also am constantly surprised.
Because you're better than us.
No. No, I'm saying, like, you know, you play through, like, a conversation with...
Thunderdome's getting real now.
You gotta have a conversation with somebody, your boss, your ex-wife, whoever the fuck you might... You know, and you kind of like, okay, how's this gonna go? And you talk it out in your head, and then when you actually have the conversation, it goes completely different. It's not that it goes bad, and, like, that preparation for that I find helpful, but I don't get locked into that mode where, like, oh, I've got this person figured out already and I know what they're going to say and what their reaction is and extrapolate everything from there.
Right.
I just try to take it from a point of I can only control what I think and not what somebody else thinks, and just go at it.
Do you really do that, or is that just something you're saying?
No, I really do that.
I question that. Not that I believe you, but I think a lot of people say that, and a lot of people will put forth that idea. But I think when they get home and they're in the darkness of their bedrooms and they're sitting there thinking about the course of the day or the people they've interacted with, I don't think they do that at all.
Yeah, but that portion is irrelevant. It's how you actually react and act on the situation. It's like if I'm
If
it's like, okay, I'm not like, oh my God, I care what this guy thinks. Now tonight I might be like, well, I kind of sound like an asshole, blah, 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 blah.
Welcome to the club.
Right. I heard my last podcast. It's but early. Like how I normally deal with other people in the world is I just try to control me, not the situation and not the person. I try to come at it at an honest point of view. And you know what? I've lost friends because of my over honesty to things, you know, and I don't fucking care. And I mean, I'm sad that the friendship may have ended, but on the other hand, I can't control what that person did or that person's reaction. I can't control
people, that. People love to tell you. I've run into this 100 times, and I too many times that I care to admit. I'm very direct. I'm very blunt. I'm very honest. We had this conversation last time I was here about, you know, how you said that you didn't believe that I liked the podcast until, you know.
Yeah, but yeah. That's on me, though. I also put that on me.
No, but it's an honesty thing because I don't offer that up to everybody. I don't say that I like your shit if I don't like your shit, right? So I'm very honest and very direct about that. And everybody likes that. Everybody seems to appreciate that in the abstract.
Honestly,
In the
abstract. Yeah, no, up front, man. No, you're not you, but I get, see, I'm the same you. Way. The royal you. Yeah, what I get is, when I give my opinion, hey, dude, how did my band sound? Well, man, I kind of didn't like this part or that part of this part.
Well, fuck you.
Right, and that's actually what I get. And it's well, I'm not, you asked me for my criticism, and I'm giving you constructive criticism.
Right.
It's not that I didn't like that.
Yeah, if you want me to say something you want to hear, say, wasn't my band great?
Well, yeah. Ask me a very leading question that would be thrown out.
Don't
in
ask me what I think if you don't want to hear it.
I'm going to give you a 6-year-old's answer. I'm just going to be honest about
it. And to piggyback on what Jay's saying, I would get off stage with my band and go, and this is people, some of whom I knew before the band was formed. So I took their opinion with a grain of salt.
Sure.
And then there was people that would just show up and they would come up and introduce themselves. And I'm like, hey, how's it going, man? Thanks for coming out. And they're like, oh, it's the fifth show I've called to you guys. Okay. Thanks for coming. I appreciate it. And eventually got to the point, what'd you think of the show? And a few of them would be like, well,
tonight wasn't so hot.
Yeah, tonight kind of sucked. You guys dragged at this point. You guys did this. Your drummer, blah, blah, blah. You yourself forgot this part. And I'm like, I'll take that all day over someone coming up and just patting me on
but
the back.
But you're a rarity, honestly. Because people's ego always tends to, most people's egos get in the way. They want to hear, they want to hear.
I just have trust issues. Right. I don't trust anyone that says anything good.
No, he's exactly right. You're exactly right.
I agree.
It's ego.
People want rainbows and cupcakes, man. Yeah. That's what they want. They want to hear you're the next fucking.
But they want to be able to stand up and say that I love honesty, that I really appreciate the fact that you're being honest and just be honest with me and I'm honest and blah, blah, blah.
And
blah,
they don't
blah,
talk to me.
It's an abstract thought.
But then they don't talk to
you. No, I understand that. I am very in touch with my ego, and I understand when people are bruising it, but that doesn't, I don't let that dictate my behavior. If I was in that situation, I would actually appreciate constructive criticism because that means that person was paying attention.
I'm starving for that, actually. Right. To be honest with you, since I've been doing this podcast, I've done, 7? 6?
I'm really good at opinions. I'll listen to your stuff and tell you if it sucks.
I'll tell you to fuck off, too.
Here we go.
I'm starving for that. I get so many people that listen to it, it's just great. It's just great. It reminds me of when we were doing radio. You remember the sandwich technique? We'd go and sit in the program director's office when you were listening to the air check, and they'd say something the sandwich technique is something
the
positive.
Compliment sandwich.
Right, and then they criticize you.
Right.
And find something
critical. Oh, yeah, that's managing people. That's,
fuck that. You know what? You think I can't see through that? Fuck
you. I would rather
tell me what you think.
I would rather give you what I thought, my negative. And then I would also tell you the positives.
Sure, balance it out.
Because it's not just for your ego or what I care. It's just hey, man, I thought this was great. So, you don't need room and improvement here. So, focus here.
Parse the phrase. Constructive
as a
criticism.
As a management technique, I know I've used that before. And the people that you have to use that with. There's a certain type of person that's just not going to be receptive to what you're saying unless you pad that. And then there's other people that you know that you can talk directly to and go, you're fucking up. Because you have a relationship where they know you are normally a good employee or whatever the fuck the relationship is, and now you're fucking up, so now I'm going to call you out.
So it's your responsibility as a manager to worry about somebody else's self-esteem.
Yeah, yes.
See, to me, that doesn't compute. I don't.
Then you can't manage people these days.
No, people. Like, it's not on you.
Guys.
That's people's ability to handle.
You've got to be adaptive. Yeah.
Hold on. There's a difference between worrying about their self-esteem and knowing how to deal with an employee who is a good employee, mm-hmm. but you know that they're capable of more. They just don't know it themselves yet. But some people need a kick in the ass. Some people need a pat on the back. Some people just need to be left the fuck alone and do their job.
I agree.
And you have to be able to identify.
I see that.
At the end of the day, it's how effective are you? Are you getting your?
I told
point?
You.
Yes, thank you. At the end of
what I'm saying.
At the end of the day, it is all about did your point get across?
I see.
So it's not really about Sure, you have to because we're not talking about personal relationships. If I had somebody in my personal relationship that I had to constantly pad my language, then I would probably eventually stop talking to that person because it would be exhausting.
Yeah. This is why
I'm not in management, honestly, because it's honestly I am like this all the time. Like I go to work, I'm like this, I'm at home.
What industry are you in?
Security and audiovisual.
Okay. Security thing, kind of makes sense. Audiovisual, now that you're here, and I wasn't eavesdropping on you guys' conversation in the kitchen when I was eating. Because believe me, I'm fat. I was mostly...
No, I got it.
All you could hear is chewing.
I don't think you're fat. I think you're fuckably plump.
I agree, man.
See you later in the shower, motherfucker.
More cushion for the pushing, baby.
Hey, look at that side tit facing. I mean, don't you want to... Come on, you can puncture that.
When you're in doubt enough, you can handle a chubby.
You know,
all my friends with small dicks like small women. I'm like, because you can't reach it. You know what I'm saying?
I can get past this fucking belly and in there.
And here's the thing. A woman who's a big woman will be like, oh, you think I got a gut? Yeah, I got a gut. I lift it up. There's some good pussy under this gut. They'll let you know. You know what I'm saying?
I'm thinking, instead of plastic surgery for you, all we need is a couple of shark hooks. We take a shark hook on each side boob. Fucking lift that shit up. Oh yeah.
And it's wings.
Oh yeah.
That was the Pierce one I ripped
touch
out.
Me,
so
touch
you,
me.
You want my mangled nipple, I know you do.
I gotta get to go to the bathroom.
Yeah, exactly.
Euphemism.
Euphoria. What?
Oh, good. You know, this. I gotta say, guys, I think this is the best podcast on the internet at this point in time.
What? I think. This the business end of your crack pipe is hot to the touch.
Yeah, this is great. This is fucking great. Who else talks about shark hook in your tits, global warming, and Ebola in the same
and right after concealed carry? Yeah.
I have to conceal these babies. You know what I'm saying? I can't let the side hangers out.
You can't conceal that shit.
Flopping around getting all the phallic symbols in the house hot. I can't have that.
Rub it again.
Do that again.
You want it from the side or from the front?
Make a little gag noise.
There you go.
Make a little gag noise.
All right.
Isn't it great when you're getting a blowjob and some gags on your dick? The only thing better is when you're fucking a chick and all of a sudden you just hear. It's like, that's right, air, get the fuck out. There ain't room for nothing. So, my dick is so big.
Let me get this straight.
Air's got to get the fuck out.
We were just talking about managerial techniques.
Yes,
right?
We were. Yes. And then we started talking about vaginas, which is takes managerial
on
techniques.
On Richmond Pod on ChristopherMedia.net. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Let me introduce a non sequitur.
You can donate today, by the way.
TuzzleX.com.
What? So I was reading a story on BBC's website about why chicken, lamb, pork, and beef are the normal meats, right? And it was talking about the different types of meats that different cultures either around the world now or historically have consumed.
Vagina, the other white meat. Go ahead.
To start with, are we all meat eaters here?
Yeah.
Okay.
I can't eat pork, but yeah.
No pork?
What are you, a Muslim?
Can't.
Fuck no.
Physically, Jewish? Or like,
no.
Okay.
It's a physical thing?
IBS.
Oh.
I'm IBS, man. Yeah, no, it makes me shit my brains out.
Oh, well,
yeah.
He does that every podcast.
Yeah, so, I do, but I can
load up on some sweet sour pork. It tastes so wonderful, man.
Pork does that to you?
Yeah, totally.
Really?
It fucks me right up.
Wow. Irritable bowel syndrome, by the way. So. I have it, too.
At least it's not Crohn's.
I shit my pants as soon as we came down here.
Yeah. There's some.
I thought that was me.
Some animals that they talk about in contrast to that: rabbits, goats, and horses that are consumed in other cultures. So,
guess what's going on in here tonight? Could it be
damn vaporizer pen?
Excuse me. Right now.
Good for you.
Huh?
Good for you.
Bad oh, no. I
no,
will,
no, I just mean, okay, like, yeah.
I will partake after we're done.
No, I will,
or
too.
Or, like, give me the 10-minute, like, warning after, light, and I'll be like...
Shh. After the bar. So we got to go find...
we're not going to... What, oh. Do you have money?
Yeah.
Well, shit, let's go now and have a podcast from there.
Okay. Can we take this on the road?
Chris, where's your fucking portable mic?
I got a portable recorder that you can take.
I have one, too.
Just live from the traffic light, it's Christopher Media.
No, no, we'll check. Really, you guys keep doing the podcast, and we'll call. And
we'll phone in, do
phoners. Yeah, we're like... There's not a whole lot of talent out here in Southfield. Southfield, where the fuck we at? St. Clair Shores.
We have a Persian over here in the corner. She has long dark hair, possibly a lesbian. But I've sent Rich over to do recon. Perhaps we'll have a Persian harpooning later on this evening.
Oh no, she doesn't like penis.
Oh. Okay. So anyway, sorry. We're hijacking this.
BBC
meat, pork, beef.
Pork. You got talking about pork.
You want some meat to pork
lamb.
And beef.
I'm just trying to keep you deviated
about
the rails.
Little chicken.
I've had rabbit before. Have you guys ever had rabbit?
Yeah, mm-hmm. 2 weeks ago I was at...
did you?
Awesome pfeffer.
You can't survive on that.
No, you can't. No.
No. I've had rabbit stew, and I've had rabbit I don't know, I guess it was...
It's too lean.
I don't know.
Yeah. I was at...
starve on it if you...
I was at Green Dot Stables, and they had a rabbit burger with a cranberry Dijon mustard glaze, which was... Phenomenal, by the way.
You're an American because that sounds delicious.
Dijon mustard.
Dijon. He's a French motherfucker.
I ain't French, goddamn it.
Then it's Dijon.
Look at this. I got American flag tattooed on my arm.
Is that Pac-Man?
No.
It looks like Pac-Man on the outside of Pac-Man.
That's what happens when you get a tattoo at Gibraltar.
That looks like fucking Pac-Man.
Which one does?
What are you talking about?
The shape on the right. What is that?
This right here?
I'm not seeing this.
That's a right. It looks like Pac-Man from here.
It's an eagle.
Are you blind? That is a bald eagle.
It's not very bald, though. I got hair on that shoulder, so it's kind of gross. But anyways, thanks for saying it's bald.
Well, goats. Don't let Pac-Man eat your American flag on your shoulder.
Have we all had goat meat? No. Really?
Goat, no.
Yes.
Have you had alligator?
You know why I've had goat meat?
No goat, no rabbit?
You know why I've had goat meat? Because I fucking hate goats.
Why look at the Arabic guy?
Yeah, I was going to say, you're Lebanese.
Have you had goats?
That's lamb.
Have you slept with goat?
Yeah, I've had lamb.
Well, I'm Scottish.
Yeah,
so
I had lamb the other day. I had a euro.
Yeah.
But lambs are goats. Yeah. I've had goat.
Okay.
But horse. No, nobody here has had horse, right?
Not knowingly.
Not knowingly. I've eaten at Chinese restaurants.
I would try it,
definitely.
Yeah, I'd like try it.
Why is there such a stigma against horse? That's like the...
It's a personalized thing.
Well, that's like dog and getting cat. A cat. Yeah. It's like dog and cat. And I'd try that, too. I don't care.
I would try anything.
It's already dead.
Oh,
I'm not cooking it.
We know we're going to try anything.
If I'm not cooking it, I'll eat it. Whatever.
I'd eat a person before I'd eat a cat.
I'd do that, too, but I'd eat a cat.
You know, yeah.
I don't like people.
I don't like cats.
I like cats.
Have you heard about
I like dogs.
I guess a pop-up restaurant is a new thing that you can do now.
A pop-up restaurant?
Yeah.
That's a new fad.
Where just like, you know, they rent a space and they make
like
a
pop-up camper?
No, it's a regular retail space, but they just, it's not a permanent installation.
They'll rent a bar. Sometimes they'll rent a bar. Like I've seen like Slows is they've rented a bar out and they've done a pop-up.
Yeah,
restaurant thing, and they like offer stuff that they don't offer in their store.
Oh, okay, I got you.
In their restaurant, they'll like pop up like, and some people who can't afford a restaurant and they're chefs or whatever, and they want you to try their, you know, food or whatever.
Their wares.
Yeah, their wares. I was going to say wares, and I'm like, it's not a shirt. You know? So they'll rent out like you were saying, they'll rent out a retail space or a bar or something of that nature. Well,
there's one that's doing human burgers to promote the new season of Walking Dead.
Where?
Get the fuck out of here.
No. It's
people.
Oh,
it's Soylent Green.
I don't know how you even get to this, but they tried to engineer this and flavor this beef in a certain way so that it tasted like human flesh.
Human beings taste like beer and cigarettes if they're American. And a little bit of gunpowder.
That still looks like Pac-Man. Snap. Show me that again. That still looks like
what
Pac-Man.
The fuck?
Look at that thing. It looks like
does
Pac-Man.
Not look
I can't
like fucking see Pac-Man. It. That is not it does not. Pac-Man. You need glasses.
It's not Pac-Man. It's old.
Look at the whole shape of it. It looks like Pac-Man from over here.
Dude,
it's nothing. Slips. It's what? Got two eyes.
Man, get back on
Pac-Man
that
had two eyes.
No, you only had the one eye.
It looks like the Pac-Man ghost thing.
Hey,
it looks more like
okay,
Pac-Man.
I'll take the ghost.
Pac-Man.
I'll take the Pac-Man ghost.
Hey, Todd, hold up. Fuck that. You brought that fucking fireball down here. Don't tempt me with a good time. Pass that shit.
Yeah.
Okay, Jim.
What's up?
YouTube pretty.
They supplement you, bitch. Uh-huh. We talked about this.
Here's some answers for you.
I'll throw some change at you.
What about your communitarianism?
Two beers.
What about your communitarianism?
I brought them.
I mean, they just blew that out.
Yeah, I know, right? No, as long as it's not his buzz.
Hey, he's a fucking alcohol fascist.
So I brought the bag of beer.
Jim Tomlinson.
Let's make a trip.
Jim Tomlinson is a freelance chef.
I knew this for one.
Jim Tomlinson. He creates exotic dishes for special events.
I got you two. Hanging here.
I know you do, and I'm taking it. I'm over your cheek.
You need a button.
This is getting really
just
weird,
shut all the
it?
Mics off.
I know. We really do.
You just need
this
a button.
Thing like just constantly dropping.
You need a freaking. You need an auto mixers that just like makes it so only two mics can be on at the same time.
Well, actually, it is kind of. I got a. By the way, for the Toddzilla X-Pod at ChristopherMedia.net, also at ToddzillaX.com on the internet. I got an arm. I got one of these. Got a Heil.
And it. Yeah.
You, no, I didn't get a Heil. I got a.
But anyways, go on with your human story.
Heil.
Whole lot of rumbling in my earphones.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, so Tomlinson is this guy.
And stumbling
it, don't
over.
Throw it.
He's the chef who invented this human burger.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Be careful with it.
He said he took inspiration from Asai Sawaga. God damn it.
Is this one of them Japanese horror directors?
Asai Sagawa, a Japanese cannibal who was interviewed in 2010 by Vice. And in the 1993 film Alive, based on a true story of a Uruguayan rugby team.
Yeah, the rugby team, yeah.
Yeah, so we all know that. So that's where he got his information from as to what human flesh might taste like. From the guys who inspired the film Alive, and from a Japanese serial killer who ate his victims.
I have an easier way to do that, by the way. Just pour it in your mouth and spit it in the beer.
No, there's homeless guys down there.
Okay.
Sorry, anyways.
Some people might think that you're still talking about tasting human flesh.
No, I was talking about
that. Oh, no, that's exactly what I thought you were talking about. That's why I said there's homeless guys down there. You think I was going to pour my fireball into a homeless guy's cock?
No, I was like,
kill a homeless guy and eat him.
I was like, how is Todd going to tie this into the conversation we're having? But I was like, let you run with it, sir.
Jesus, Jay.
I was just coming up with a MacGyver way of putting your fireball in your fucking
you're
beer.
You're a fucking cannibal.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, there's an easier way. You just don't consume the human flesh. You just chew it up and then spit it out into a cup. And you're not actually a cannibal.
This is literally the best podcast on the entire internet, folks. Yeah. ChristopherMedia.net, the unregimented pod. Also
actually,
at ToddZillaX.com.
Sorry. Okay.
Have any liners you want
to
read?
You can donate to it. You can also donate.
What?
As long as we have to ask the question, though, as long as we're talking about this.
About what?
About eating human flesh. Right. I mean, if you had to, would you?
Absolutely. If I had to?
Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yours first.
Yeah.
Wait, whoa,
really?
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Who would you eat? No, actually.
I'm all muscle.
Sorry.
I know who's getting eaten.
Yeah.
Here's the bitch of it. Unless you kill me, I'm going to outlast all y'all.
No, I kill you.
Because I got the meat.
I kill you. I would definitely kill you.
Actually, no, I'd die from dehydration because I drink as much as I do.
I'd kill you.
Okay.
Yeah. You would be. I think we'd hang out well. Say we're in the Donna party. Say this is like a wagon where we're riding up the Sierras and all of a sudden we're fucking snowbound and we're sitting here podcasting and starving. And we're going to be all looking at
first
each other.
First of all, everybody shut up. Stop wasting all the oxygen.
You know, I know what he would say. He'd be like, you know what? You want a blowjob?
Oh, God.
Who
the
would
five
say
of us you would. Trapped
like, you that's exactly what I was
because
saying.
Because like, you're not going to say
this
no.
This is what Todd would do. Todd would go, first of all, it'd be like one of those Looney Tune cartoons where the two guys are stranded on the island. And I start looking like a hamburger.
Oh, you already do.
Yeah, well, you look like a hot dog, sir, so I guess we're good.
Yeah, exactly. I'm safe.
Second of all, he would just wait till I was asleep and like just kill me. And then when he ate me, he'd go, "That's now you're part of me, dog. We're always together." You know what I'm saying? Like he would rationalize the shit.
Yeah. No, I would be like, "You know what, dog? I just ate you. I'm gonna shit you out in about a day and a half, and we're done.
And then I'm gonna eat you again for the moisture.
You know, if I need to.
Yeah. You know, hey, rabbits do it.
No, I would definitely. Hey, we're cannibalism, stuck in the. I mean, if we're a Donner Party, if we're a live thing, yeah.
It's like the fucking. Wait a minute. Hold on. This isn't good. Well, the last time I saw you do this right in the middle of a conversation.
No, he's...
Okay.
Yeah, he's fixing it.
In all seriousness, I would not kill someone to do that. I think I would die first before I would kill someone to eat them. But if somebody else was already dead and they'd already gone, yeah.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Survival? You'd be amazed what you'll do to survive when your back's put to the wall.
Okay. I agree with that, too.
All right, yeah. So let's
I have a bug-out bag.
All right, next step, let's take survival off the plate and say that you're...
Just hungry?
In your foreign country... And the chef assures you that the man died of natural causes.
Absolutely not.
I'm freaking chewing on that shit, man.
Absolutely not.
No way. All you have is you have the opportunity to just taste it,
Aaron. Because I have
like
read
a piece of skin. Maybe
no. Like he's not ripping it off the body and serving it to you. I mean, he prepares a dish. He gives you, you know.
And all I have to do is
a
take
nice
a bite.
Flank steak.
All I have to do is take a bite.
Yeah,
you're offered a bite.
Absolutely not. You're no, I'm not. No, I don't. I wouldn't.
You wouldn't just out of curiosity.
No, I would let you do it and ask you.
Hey, Aaron, go ahead.
Because I'm going to be in that country. I would not be in that country by myself.
I'm not sure if I would do it.
I'm not sure if I would either. And I think because, maybe if I was if I was by myself,
I would have.
I would
a hard
be
time.
Really tempted. Yeah, if nobody else would know, and I was I was by myself. Yeah. I think I might be tempted.
I couldn't do
it. I might get the case of the fuck.
I don't think I could do monkey. Would you eat a monkey? I don't think I could do that.
You got a nasty case of them shits. Just give me that fucking whole human foot. There we go.
Did you guys ever see
brains little of toe. Anything. I like toes.
Satisfies two fantasies.
Did you guys ever see the faces of death from the 1980s?
I could not
do that. Where they're beating the shit out of the monkey skull and they cut it open.
I wanted to come to that screen.
That's why. I don't think I could do it.
I want to go through that screen and beat the hell out of that guy. Because it's not necessary. Like if you're in a necessity, like man.
Like, that's like
they will claim it is. They will claim
it
is because they will say that the fear of the monkey is feeling releases certain chemicals into the brain, which actually gives the brain a certain flavor. They actually claim that.
Yeah, great. You can have that flavor.
I don't eat it.
Yeah. Tastes like monkey fear.
I mean,
exactly.
I wonder if come out that with that vape
I'll tell
flavor.
You what, if you want to like take me on a monkey hunt, like dude, I'll go.
No,
hunt
I'm not
going to
kill a monkey.
But I'm not going to like
I'll
bash his
fuck.
Brain.
I'll hunt a monkey.
Well, no, I mean like that monkey in that movie, they like strapped it into a freaking table and
locked into the middle of the table.
I wouldn't do that.
I have figured out. You've just helped me. Thank you very much, Jay. I have figured out a scenario whereas I would eat human.
All right.
Okay.
If we could go on a Republican hunt with a big gun, a big sidearm, perhaps, preferably, a concealed carry.
Oh, here we go.
And we're running through the woods, perhaps in Kansas, maybe northern Michigan, or
I will interrupt
Utah.
You and say good luck with that.
No,
I take that Republican's going to have a fucking AR up his butt and a shotgun.
You don't realize how motivated and stealthy I can be.
They have bug out bags.
Stealthy, good adjective.
Yeah. And they might just outnumber you.
I have Jesus. Have you listened to my podcast?
So
I have Jesus. I literally have Jesus. Talks to him.
Is he like a little bobbly guy right now?
No, he actually has conversations with
Todd. Blasphemer motherfucker.
Yes, I am.
It's fucking Jesus you're talking about,
man. Hey, you want to find out who's going to win the Super Bowl?
Call up my podcast. Let's
Jesus
hear this
already,
you want to hear me talk to Jesus? I got him.
I'm good for you.
All right. No, I do.
I know Jose.
Yeah, I get my weed from him, and he cuts my lawn once a week.
That's horseshit.
What?
Fucking mocking his name. Taking his name, Jose Vane.
Yeah, I will.
By the way, that would be great. Service.
Anyway, in the vein of what?
Cut your lawn and bring you your weed?
Yeah, cut your grass and bring you some?
We take care of both your grass needs.
If I could hunt and shoot and fillet and broil, it's got to be broiled. My own Republican, I would eat that shit. I'd put Bill O'Reilly. I think I'd eat him.
He would taste better. He'd taste better.
Mayonnaise, I'm thinking, no, he's aged. Yeah. He's aged.
Be kind of like pastrami, you know?
Yeah. Pastrami. I like pastrami. I like my meat. I really want it tender. I want a little rubbery.
Man, fuck this. Talk about food in front of a fat guy because I'm thinking like pastrami mustard, little pickle on an onion
roll.
That's
what I just had today, man. That spicy mustard like with some freaking pepper jack cheese.
My dick hasn't been hard when I woke up in the morning for the last 6 months.
My dick hasn't been hard.
You're welcome.
The last 6 months.
Jesus, I'm glad I could do that for
Monday
you.
Monday hasn't been hard in the last 6 months.
You know what I'm saying?
I just saw your belly raise a little bit right there.
Holy shit, that's not only a fucking erection, that's a scaffolding.
Yeah, yeah. It's, but Todd, hey, if my dick was holding up the Twin Towers, it wouldn't have fell.
All right.
Too soon, too soon.
Too soon, 14 years, come on.
How dare you talk about the CIA's greatest accomplishment like that?
Oh, I mean the terrorist. Ladies and gentlemen, this show is brought to you by Fireball.
Just because I'm a redhead doesn't mean you can talk about my testicles on here.
Yes, it does.
I don't want. I'm not done with this cannibalism thing yet. But
wait a minute,
so
what contract?
You're really coming at this from more of a warrior aspect of consuming the body of your enemy, right? I mean, if you're going after
just some
Bill O'Reilly.
I don't think I would consider it going after the body of my enemy as much as
consume and repurpose his energy for your own.
But it's not my enemy. It's going after and killing my inferior species on the planet.
But I don't want that in my body.
No, but that's what happens. The weaker meat and the strong shall eat. The weak, the intellectually weak, Bill O'Reilly, I would eat them. Yeah, definitely. I think we should put up like conservative Republican traps in the front yard. Perhaps near your car.
Free guns!
Are we going to put a picture of Sarah Palin and free Atlas guns. Shrugged and, you know, a couple other little things? And it's going to be like a glue trap?
What can we use? What can we use for our Republican...
free guns.
Our neocon trap.
Yeah, free guns.
Put a little gun. Any kind of fucking plastic gun, you put that in there. That's good.
No, it's got to be an AR, man.
It's got to be more than seven
rounds.
You should have a Ted Nugent albatross plane.
Yes.
To lure them to...
Wango tank.
You get the Ted Nugent Bronco.
That's the Duck Dynasty can make.
No. What you do is...
You have Sarah Palin in a bikini. Ted Nugent plane.
I know. Wango Tango on the big fucking speaker on top of the house to lure him in. Sort of like the... I don't know what the fuck.
Yeah, but you can't play Stranglehold because then you'll get the Hendrix fans.
No, Wango Tango. It's got to be Wango Tango. Wang dang, sweet poon dang.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you get all the mouth breathers on that one.
Especially here. So you asked. So, yeah, I'm thinking that's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking it's not an ideological thing and not sort of a political. I think it's just I would like to consume the bodies of my intellectual inferiors.
Can we just do a speed round on this subject before we close it up? Right? I'll just throw out an animal and you tell me yes or no if you would eat it.
All right.
So, we know you haven't consumed rabbit, would you?
Yeah.
Okay. Hamster.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. How about a lion?
Yeah.
Yeah. Giraffe?
Yeah.
Okay.
How about... So have you ever had alligator?
Is there anything that you wouldn't...
It. No, just people.
You can only eat their tail. You can only eat alligator tail, but alligator tail is actually really good.
Monkeys, I wouldn't do.
Alligator is amazing.
It is amazing.
I love
it. Ostrich is amazing.
I think I would do monkeys, but I may.
You may. It's just the idea of...
just that image from Faces of Death.
I wouldn't eat anything's brains. It's like the idea of like the brains being a little bit more tasty because of the way that you kill it. It's like getting the best oyster on the planet. It's still
You're doing this to us? That's not fair. The new guy doesn't get to fucking chime in
Where do we have the new guy's stick?
You know, back in the day, we'd take you outside.
Your stick against mine.
Back in the day, we used to take guys like you out back and beat them with a rubber hose.
Yes,
you know I'm not a union guy.
He misunderstood me. You thought I said new guy Twig.
Oh. Oh,
actually,
man.
The new guy stick is what we domer you with.
Oh, bring it.
Oh,
yeah, is there any video of the Dahmer plunging?
No, that's
as long as I can take my $20,000 in teeth out before
sure
you hit me with it. I'm good.
You have $20,000 in teeth?
Yeah.
Can I have them?
No, did you play hockey, sir?
Let me see. They're $20,000.
Well, the rest of them are. Yeah.
Did you play hockey or something? What happened?
About three.
I have to have the same thing done.
No, what happened? What happened?
I guess fights and whatnot.
Yeah, I got hit with a coke bottle.
Okay. Yeah. So all right. So
I'm Irish and Scottish, man. Yeah, you put me in a room by myself, I'll come out black and blue and happy.
Yeah, you and I should not go to the bar together.
I was already debating you and I. You and I need to go to the bar together.
You and I are going to get probably just offend a bunch of chicks. He and I are going
to
be dragging.
I would have actually handed them to you, but I didn't brush them before I came over, so that's kind of nasty.
Alright, I didn't wash my hand after I jerked off.
Savon, street fighting man.
It wouldn't be the first time I've been caught.
What do you think, Aaron? You're looking a little perplexed. Has this podcast evolved a little bit too much for you?
No.
I think we need to take Aaron to the bar with us three. I think we need to take Aaron to the bar with us three and pick a fight.
And throw him
for him.
Okay.
Be like, you see that guy over there?
He said you're a fucking pussy.
He said your left jab couldn't break wind, motherfucker.
Let's
go over there and handle it.
I'll take
that.
A beat.
Beat.
All right.
Okay, we're taking it.
Now, let's talk about fighting stuff.
Oh, sorry. My bad. Handshake.
There's going to be two of us talking, well, maybe three, talking about this. So.
Oh, no, he's got the Bob Probert teeth.
So do I.
That sounds like a motorcycle accident. He's bullshitting us. Yeah. That's impressive, sir. Yeah.
Because that's another thing that I don't understand.
Yeah, I got a couple, too.
Getting in fights with guys. Right, I had a friend who I went to the bar with, and he had a couple drinks, and he just started looking around, and he was like, "One of these motherfuckers is getting their ass beat tonight." And
so I'm like, "We never went to the bar, Aaron.
What are you talking about?"
I was such a fucking redneck. I thought he was joking. Get a job to get paid to get into fights.
Yeah,
that's how much of a redneck I was. See, and then I got glasses. And then I don't want to get hit in the face.
Yes, doesn't that change? Well, doesn't that change?
Like, oh, yeah, cool. I'm carrying a gun now. I got glasses.
Yeah, I ain't got time for all that bullshit. I'll just shoot you.
I got $20,000 in my mouth and like, you know, $300 on my face. Yeah.
I'll just shoot your ass.
No, I'll run with that.
Here's 50 cents.
Again, it goes back to what we were saying earlier. I don't know. This is a really complex thought, and I don't know if I can put it together, but it goes back to what I was saying earlier about how people are collectively just fucked in the head. And I think what you're addressing here is something that comes from like 100 fucking thousand years ago. And it's the alpha male bullshit that you see in dogs. It's a guy that walks into a bar, gets drunk, and he thinks he's got to go swing his dick through his fists at somebody in the fucking bar. He's got to establish his dominance and who he is as a human being and as a man.
I think it comes more from a place of not knowing how to internalize your own problems and analyze things introspectively, and just
guys,
you would rather get that anxiety out.
Go jerk off. You got the fucking internet.
No, not for somebody who wants to walk into a bar and just pick a fight with somebody.
I want to.
A lot of these people have not developed their inner sense of fuck it. Yeah. That's really what it comes down to.
I want to piggyback on what you're saying, because Monday's podcast, we touched upon a domestic violence thing, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Is that where you ass fucked me?
Yeah. That wasn't that violent. Video? That was loving.
Is that on video?
Well, thank.
Actually, I think it is.
1999 at ToddZillaX.com.
I'll pay 99 cents.
But they're saving that to release.
I'll buy that for a dollar.
No, 99 cents.
99 cents. I'll give you your change. I got a penny here. Hold on a second.
We're saving the video so we can charge for it.
I was telling these guys, these two gentlemen here on the ride up that I found out just through talking to people about certain subjects at work that I got a lot of people at work that listen to our podcast and they don't tell me about it.
Oh, yeah.
And one of the subjects come up was the domestic violence thing. And my manager is gay. And he's like, dude, pretty much down the line, male, female, all agreed that, like, if you go in a relationship and you're in a relationship and you start swinging at the other person, you should probably expect to get your ass whipped.
Yeah.
And I was like, would you say that?
You're in the wrong relationship.
Hold on. Listen to me. And I said, okay. So that's how you guys feel. Would you say that on a mic? And they said, oh, God, no. No.
That's exactly how I feel. I'm not just putting it out there because I'm on a microphone. If I thought that you should get your ass kicked or you should be able to hit a woman back, I would say it.
No, but wait a minute. This is different. This was a gay guy talking about. I was talking about him and his boyfriend. He goes, here's the thing.
That's two men.
That's two.
Yeah.
How's it different than two women beating on each other?
We're talking about a woman hitting a man, and he has a right to hit her back. You weren't talking about two lesbians.
Someone unplug
fighting.
His mini USB that will run out in a second. Because it was domestic violence is what I brought up. Run the tape back. That's what I said. What I just said was domestic violence. I didn't say anything about a man and a woman. You inferred that. That's your problem.
You actually said no. We weren't talking about woman on woman violence. What we were talking about last week in the last podcast had nothing to do with lesbians beating on each other or gay couples.
No, it doesn't. But they listened to it and they happen to be gay, so the conversation came up. That's hence the new subject that I'm bringing up. I'm not talking about last week. Last week sparked the conversation. I asked them flat out, if you and your boyfriend get into a fight, what would you do if the cops showed up? Like, you lived in an apartment complex. He goes, we'd look at each other and go, we're roommates, we got an argument, no big deal. And the cops would leave. It would not be a domestic violence situation. No one would have to take anger management classes.
Right.
Nothing. And I asked my lesbian coworker, what would happen if you and your girlfriend got into a fight? And she goes, oh, we'd both start screaming, this bitch is cheating on me, and I'll beat this bitch's ass. And I'm like, So you would instantly throw not just the card, the victim card, the whole fucking deck at the cops, both of you.
You're both busted.
And she went, yes. And I said, well, isn't that fucked up? I mean, this is a conversation we had at work, and it's just amazing how people of, we're all people, you know what I'm saying, obviously, but people of different sexual orientations. the jury's still out on some of us. Yeah. And but anyways, but yeah, it just how people of different sexual orientations viewed this subject. And I was just, it amazed me because I was like, okay, so women on man on woman violence, you guys are wrong. You know, that you guys are like, yep, that's wrong. But if you're in a gay relationship and
gender,
you beat on your partner.
Gender equal situations, yeah.
Yeah, they were like, no, that's perfectly fine. What?
Actually, I'm...
How about this? How about violence isn't the first resort, right. Period. It's the absolute last, not the first.
So if you're getting your face bashed in by a woman, what do you do?
What did I do?
What would you do? Like, how do you feel?
This is the conversation we had last podcast. But we can't make it that general. I mean, if you're saying you're getting your face bashed in, like, if I am fearing for my safety, yes, I'm going to defend myself. But I have never been struck. I've been struck by women. I've never been struck by a woman and feared for my safety.
So when the woman struck you, what was your reaction?
I took it.
You took it.
One time there was a
because
a number,
men are supposed to take abuse and women aren't.
No, it's not because I'm supposed to. It's because I can.
We're rehashing old ideas. Because it's a disadvantage.
Like, how are you hit?
It's like a little kid.
Smack or
if a 5-year-old hits you. It's the same idea as if a 5 or a 10-year-old hits you. You don't punch him back in the nose.
My 11-year-old nephew, like, hits me. I don't go, what, you know, wham. I don't fucking.
No. But I'm talking about. I was going through a haunted house with my uncle when I was 5 years old. And someone jumped out, and I turned around and punched him in the balls. And you know what he said? See you when you're 20, motherfucker. Well, actually, he probably left out the motherfucker. Well, no, he wasn't saved at that point. He probably said motherfucker. But he was like, I'll see you when you're 20. It's just, it was a joke. But yeah, he didn't do anything. And you know, you get hit in your balls, your instinct is to do something about it.
Yeah.
Your instinct is to protect yourself. Okay, I got that. But what I'm saying is, I found it amazing in a conversation we had, filtered through a gay male and a gay female, was they were like, no, I'm totally, fuck that. My boyfriend hits me, I'm knocking that motherfucker's dick in the dirt.
If you're generally,
and I'm like, really?
Generally equal, I can see that. I don't know.
If you love someone, you don't fucking strike them in the first place.
Well, that's where you should be.
Right.
Yeah.
So, I mean...
You should reassess your love into this. Yeah,
What the fuck a relationship is, right?
You should really reassess your relationship at that point. If you feel that you have to physically harm somebody for any reason whatsoever,
then you don't need to be friends with them. You don't need to be in a relationship with them.
I mean, even in a friendship.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I've had friends as I got older. They still think it's cool to fight.
We're painting in very broad strokes here. I mean, are we talking about continued abuse? Or are we talking about a one-time incident?
I'm talking about flat-out physical abuse, not emotional abuse, which we heap upon each other as human beings every day, and we call it tough love.
There's a difference between you're in a relationship with somebody, and you get into some sort of argument that gets escalated to the point where somebody throws a blow.
Like you two are about to throw at each other.
I'm not saying that's right, and I'm not trying to justify it, but I am saying that it is very different than either sex or either party in any relationship systematically, like getting drunk, whether, you know, getting drunk on the weekends or coming home every day, and it's like a battle. You know, there's a difference between getting in a fight and being abused.
I agree.
What I'm talking about is the passive-aggressive abuse that I see people in relationships heap upon each other every day.
I think you guys are talking about the same thing, maybe we are.
And we turn a blind eye to it, and we go, oh, whatever.
Well, we discount.
And it's that shit that beats people down over time. And in a long-term relationship, you can get beat down.
Yeah, we discount. We do discount mental abuse. We really do.
I mean, seriously, it's like here's one of my favorite passive aggressive things that people do. When you bring up something that they don't like, they go, "What are you talking about? I don't understand. What are you trying to say? I don't understand. Don't fucking play stupid with me. You know what the fuck I'm talking about. If you didn't, you would go, wait a minute, hold on a sec. That doesn't make any sense. What do you mean? Okay, obviously we have
what are you talking
about? I'm listening.
I don't understand.
I know silent words, and this dude ain't talking.
Dude, I just want you
would you like another beer?
You've seen the movie Up?
No.
You've seen the movie
Up? No.
I thought you wanted a beer.
Squirrel!
Oh, squirrel.
You know what I'm talking about? Yeah. That board that's leaning up against that wall over there?
Yeah.
That just totally grabbed my attention out of the blue, and I was just sitting here like looking at it.
Well,
like,
thanks for engaging my ADD. I'd like to get back to
it. In other words,
Yeah, shiny.
Well, I should do this to get your attention.
I thought there was a girl with yoga pants behind us or something. I mean, I thought there was yoga
I thought Jennifer Connelly like, called for an emergency titty fuck. Yeah, let's and have I turned around and it was just a board.
Let's have an episode of ChristopherMedia.net Craigslist. Do you want to sell
it? Possibly.
Hey guys, thanks for listening, thanks for clicking, thanks for liking, thanks for sharing, thanks for subscribing for free by clicking through the iTunes banner on ChristopherMedia.net. Thank you for telling a friend. I probably already said that, but that's how important it is because that's how podcasts work, man. It's the days of pirate radio, sorta, kinda. Just please tell somebody. We drop every Monday and Thursday. Check out all of the other shows on ChristopherMedia.net. Make sure you're checking out The Weedsman, you're checking out Eminem, you are checking out Mr. Toddzilla. We got a couple new shows kicking around too. A lot of people are starting to notice what we're doing. They want to get involved, so big things might be happening. So stay tuned, thanks for listening, and we will catch you next time.
If you enjoy this show and want more people to know about it, head on over to iTunes, leave a comment, and rate it 5 stars. Make sure you like and share us on Facebook, and don't forget to follow us on Twitter. Just search for Christopher Media. Thank you in advance for supporting Christopher Media by clicking on the PayPal button and by clicking through to all the sponsors who support ChristopherMedia.net. Most importantly, we would like to take the time to extend an extra special thanks to you. Christopher Media could not exist without your support. Thank you for visiting ChristopherMedia.net, and thank you for listening. Christopher Media. Let's make some noise.
Slack is a new way to communicate with your team. It replaces email with something faster, better organized, and more secure. Every conversation has its own channel that's easy to join, search, or create, and it's all integrated. You can attach info from thousands of apps, share files, make calls, everything you need to get your work done. Welcome to your new headquarters.